Oh, and a good Wednesday morning to you. Welcome in here to the first half of the celebration of 1 year on Twitch. Yeah. Crazy how time has flown. I can't believe I've been doing this for a year now. I've met one of my personal goals of hitting 100 followers. Did that last week, and when I started, I think I maybe had like three or four, but they were just kind of, you know, they were friends that we just followed each other on Twitch. And yeah, hit 100 followers. Let's see, when was that? April 12th, so yeah, last Tuesday. But yeah, so one of my personal goals I had for the stream itself, and hopefully, yeah, okay, whew, sorry, I saw a buffer there for a second, but one of the personal goals I had for the stream itself was hitting 100 followers, and managed to do that. I was extremely excited, I was extremely thrilled, and I'm extremely thankful to everyone as well who has followed me here, and for those who have continued to come back and are at this point regular viewers on the stream. I certainly thank everyone there, but decided to mix things up. Normally on the short morning sports stream, do a little NBA 2K16 My Career. That's kind of been the main point here lately. But with the 1 year anniversary, decided to throw back to the Madden series because that's what I started streaming in the first place. I did these like little shorts, sometimes anywhere from a half an hour to an hour, maybe a little bit more, of Madden 15 Ultimate Team for a while until 16 came out, which I didn't get right away. Got later, and that's kind of when I made the transition point from going to playing Madden to playing NBA 2K16 instead. But because of the 1 year anniversary, decided to do a little throwback to the Madden series where, like I said, I basically got my start in streaming. Back then it was really crappy, choppy streams because I had bad internet there. That was barely able to push out a stream, so there was a lot of skipping, a lot of choppiness and that, which is why I stuck to just playing Madden Ultimate Team, because I couldn't play multiplayer games or anything like that. It was one game that seemed to give the most stability with the internet I had at that time. So while I thought about doing Ultimate Team, I haven't played Madden 16 a whole lot. I got it really late and really haven't built up much of an Ultimate Team. I've played it here and there, so don't have much of a team to play with Ultimate Team-wise, but I figured why not just do some Draft Champions instead. It's kind of similar to Ultimate Team, except I can build somewhat of a decent team up through this, so without further ado, now that my rambling is done, we will begin. Just going to do solo draft, just because this is basically a little one-off anniversary stream. So it's just easier just to do solo draft and all that and see what we can build. All right, let's see what we got here. 3-4, 3-4. All right, I tend to stick with 4-3. I've always been better at running a 4-3 defense than a 3-4, so I guess since Quinn's my only choice, we'll go with Quinn. All right, let's see here.
Boy, we've just gotten started here, and already these guys have been handed a really difficult decision to make.
Yeah, thank you very much. I'm just looking at my base team, what I already have. Okay. Mike Vick and Geno Smith as my quarterbacks. That's interesting. I this is one of the modes I've played a couple times. When I do play Madden, I usually jump into Draft Champions. It's a fun mode. And what I like to do is I try to build up wide receivers and defensive backs. Just so I have a good pass attack, a good, pass defense as well. I usually try to wait till later to maybe grab a quarterback. I like mobile quarterbacks too. So I think I'm going to go ahead and take Cobb here with the first pick. What to do Captain Munnerlin.
Interior of your line or get that skill player to add another weapon.
He's not all that great in man defense. So what do I have man defense was? He's about the pretty much the same as everyone else that I currently have. His zone is really good. Where do I get a pass rusher? Or do I go with a linebacker? What? I'm going to take Captain here.
There's no doubting that this guy's got talent. I'm just not sure that he's the right fit for this system.
Oof. I do like to beef up my offensive line, but I think McCourty's too good to pass up there. Needs,
but this guy is a legitimate star, and he'll make everyone around him better.
Okay, well, this gives me a chance to beef up line a little bit. Would think about taking Floyd, but I got to make sure I've got someone that a decent line that can pass block.
To begin with.
Keep getting these decent pass rushers. Let's see what we got compared to Vaccaro. Carl's got better man coverage, but then all important play rec. Oh man, this is what I like about this mode is trying to figure out what you want to do. I think I'll take Cersei and go just with the match for the system.
In these middle rounds, you have to start asking yourself, do you see?
All right, well this helps a little bit. At least I can get a pass rusher.
Whoever's making the final decision here might have a coordinator in each year.
Ooh.
Do you go offense or defense?
Sure, up the middle. And get pass protection. Oh wow, 96. I can't pass up on that.
The West Coast offense, they're going to throw the ball a lot. So in my eyes, this is a great fit.
Do need some help on man defense, so we'll take Denard.
Is he the right guy for the system they're planning to run?
There's that mobile quarterback I could use. Alright, we're going Wilson.
And with time running short, you've got to hope some guys fall into your lap, or you could be left with some real holes on your roster.
Well, yeah, we'll take
so
Boykin there.
For a coach to have guys that can buy in to the system they want to run. And I think that's why they went with this guy right here.
I'll go with Dupree. Beef up linebackers just a little bit. Oh wow, what a selection. I don't think there's much of a question. If I want to beef up my defensive backs, I've got to go with Sherman, right? Yeah, I can't pass up on getting Sherman there.
Richard Sherman of the Seattle Seahawks. Great size, and he can close down an entire half of the field.
Who do I have as my tight ends right now? Pettigrew, Paul. I run a lot of passes to my tight ends, although I don't technically have the Patriots playbook. Let's see, what do we have compared to here? I think I'll go with him.
One thing's for sure in this round, you're going to walk away with a great player no matter which way you go.
I think he'll show me man defense stats, and he'll just show me. So many choices. I'll take Daniels.
Not too much surprise. Whoa. Green Bay players in high demand. Here's a chance for another Packer to come off the board.
Sterling Sharp would help, but... Man, Walter Payton is one of my... This is just a personal pick for me. I should have probably gone with Sharp, but... Walter Payton is one of my all-time favorite legends, being a Bears fan myself. I will see how this team does. Want to make sure my defense is all... Because sometimes they short you on a cornerback. Yep. See, I like to run a lot of five sets, so I need someone else here. Who's got the best man defense stats? 80... 83. Denard again. He got his upgraded version. I guess we'll put a second Denard in there. Yeah, I think we can roll with this. It's not going to tell. I wish it would tell me man coverage, because I do have linebackers that go into man coverage every now and then. Jay Feely's my kicker. And offensive line isn't exactly the strongest. So I hope it can hold up at least well enough. Just kind of comparing to see... Better strength... Better impact. Yeah, I think I'll take the stronger impact there. Okay. I guess I... Oh, yeah. Only one center. Well, that's not really much of a choice there. Slightly higher stats. We'll test the first game, see how things work out. I'm really just mostly concerned about... didn't exactly get a strong receiving core like I normally did. Mostly because I passed up on Sterling Sharp for Walter Payton. So, maybe doing more of a rushing attack. But, alright, let's... Game number one, here we go. Reggie White. Play Ultimate Team this week. Get a bonus one. Interesting. See how good I am at Madden. I did play a little over the weekend just to kind of get a little more practice in. Plus, I'd already started a draft champion team that I hadn't finished yet. I was... one game in already, and I wanted to finish that so I could start fresh on the stream today. I got a little bit of practice. That team was way... that team I had there was really good. Way better than what I have right here.
To see what they've got and how or if these pieces are going to fit together. Their opponents in this one, the New York Giants.
And Mike Nugent looks set now to kick it away.
All right, well,
the Bears are back.
First possession
to return the kick.
I'm just going to state obvious facts the rest of the game. So, sit tight. It's going to be a thrill fest. See, he's going to be kicking the ball off now, and then I'm going to be receiving it, and then I'm probably going to get tackled.
Peyton's going to start his return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
Not a bad starting spot.
Watson's, of course, going to be the man at quarterback today. Now an experienced quarterback with 4 years under his belt.
Russell Wilson is absolutely maybe the most mobile quarterback in the NFL.
That was a little to get a big glitchy hit there.
And if there's pressure in the pocket, he will get outside and make a play.
Classic Madden. I'm doing this on purpose. This really is a throwback stream.
Take the snap from the 25.
All glitchy and choppy there. Hopefully that was just a little one-off thing. We'll keep an eye on it, though. May have to reset really quick.
They would love this. This is showing your dominance here. The offensive line doing a good job.
That's funny.
Also a solid job by the running back picking up some good yards. Jeremy Curley with the catch.
Right there to take him down.
So if I'm constantly doing this, you know I'm looking over and checking on my stream. Might have just been a little one-off glitchiness because it kind of buffered, and I think it was just catching back up.
As he's breaking out towards the sideline, that football is right on target.
Now first and 10. Catch made. Peyton's marked down after a gain of 4. As we set now, the offensive unit, Randall Cobb, one of the biggest threats in the league every time he touches the football.
Ooh, fullback inside. I didn't even see. Oh, Monte Ball's playing fullback.
You see Randall Cobb, return game, receiving yards.
Well, that's a dual back attack.
Run the football. Always good to have these types
Oops,
of runs.
I did not mean down, to do that.
But it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to.
Well, I hope this audible pays off. It does. Woo!
Marked down after a gain of 9.
Well, everybody talks about the pass in the NFL. When it's third and short, you got to man up and be tough and strong. Nice job that time.
I know I got a mobile quarterback for passing. Probably will come later on.
Still on his feet. Jones in on
exactly.
The
strongest receiving core, and I've got one of the best running backs to ever play the game, so why not use him?
Once in a while, when they put those arms around you, that's not going to be enough. Good job of breaking that tackle.
The Bears snap it at the 26. On the money. And that's a gain of 13.
The key to being a really good
and of course, this is on rookie mode, so it's going to be a little easy. I did like how they did, and the first time I played it, I didn't realize that it upped in difficulty as you win. You start, the first game you play is on rookie difficulty, second game is pro, third game is all pro. I like how they did that to kind of up the difficulty because the goal is to win 3 games without losing one, so winning 3 straight games. And it's nice how they put a little bit of a added difficulty to it.
The Bears come out in a bunch set. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Oh, easy. Again, rookie mode, though. But, yeah, I like how they did that, so it wasn't just a wash, an easy walk in the park to get to those 3 wins. There was actually a little bit of challenge involved.
The Bears setting up for the kickoff.
You know, making it just a little bit challenging. Sorry, I'm focusing on the game and not finishing my thoughts. But making it a little more challenging as you go on. So, because you do get a pretty decent rewards out of it. If you win the soul, I'm sure you probably get even better rewards if you're playing online. But if you just do the solo challenge, you get a gold, basically a gold pack. If you win the 3 straight games, and in it is an Elite Draft Champions badge, and there are different collections and Ultimate Team to put them in, including one where you can get, if you collect 10 badges, you can get a double Elite Player pack, which is kind of one of the things I've been working towards. I just wanted to check to make sure I have the best man coverage middle linebacker. Yeah, okay, so yeah, he's the best I got.
The Giants lineup been a tight first half. The score's 7-0. The Giants come out with a split backfield. First down at the 26. Dump ball on the receiving end.
Well, you can't play man-to-man, Jim, every single play. Every once in a while, you got thrown.
And computer's completely generated, too. I mean, they've got random players as well. Actually have a decent quarterback on this one. Normally, they've got, like, Colt McCoy or Geno Smith. Once you get to All-Pro, you actually face some elite players. They have more star players on the team. Again, nice and... like amping up the difficulty as you go along. You're basically just facing either gold, low gold or silver players first game or so. And then when you get to the third game, you're facing elite and high tier gold players. So again, no cakewalk.
Peyton's going to take this one from the 26.
Which is what I like. I mean, it's you go on, you want to make it a little more challenging. It get boring if you just automatically won every time on rookie difficulty.
Yeah, let's give a lot of credit to that offensive line. They were awesome. They did everything well. Usually you have an offensive line can only do the two things well, run block or pass block. This one
might have been better off just maybe trying to hurdle there. Ooh, all right. You know, let's try bombing it out a little bit here.
He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them.
Single high safety. Woo! Look at that beautiful catch. That's how we do it.
The time of the tight end makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
Wilson's 5-for-5 after that completion.
When you run the football like this and you show
could go QB. Ooh.
There is no doubt. When you fake it,
I like airing it out every now and then.
The field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it
done. Try to get that deep pass.
The Bears from the 27.
Hang on to it, Avery.
From the red zone.
Try a little HB counter move here.
No margin for error. Just outside the goal line.
I couldn't cut. I didn't make the right move to cut back there.
Bears are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
Classic slot drive play.
There is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottled him up for a short game.
Second and goal from the 7.
I should have gone to the running back. That was a wide open path to the end zone.
If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
Play number 6 coming up on this drive.
I don't know if flanker drive is going to have enough.
The Giants with a nickel look here on defense. Third and goal from the 7.
Whoa. Oops.
Incomplete as he was looking short that time.
Yeah, you can tell I have not played this game a lot.
Should be an easy one here.
That was a wasted opportunity. I should have just run the ball.
Is through for 3. We're nearing the half, and this game looks like it might be under control.
I've never been a great Madden player in the first place. I've always been very average. If I've got a good team, I can play on all pro, no problem. All Madden is challenging, but you know, I've beaten the All Madden challenges in Ultimate Team before with strong teams and that. So I'm capable of at least getting by them, but I am no Madden expert.
Showing different formations of plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three and out business.
Well, that's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
2nd and 12. The give.
You know, I've watched those guys who are on, you know, in the like the professional tournaments and that, and just the moves and the skills and the level they're at just amazes me. It's like, wow.
The first half is complete. Larry Ridley ready to take things over back in the studios. And
they make it look so easy. And when I try to do something like that, I completely screw it up. So, yeah, I give props to any, like, professional gamers and that. A lot of times they make it look so easy. And then you play it yourself and you realize, wow, a lot harder than they make it look.
Gets out.
But they also put a lot of time and practice into it with me, where I play it like once every couple weeks, maybe.
First half performance, and here they are to begin the third quarter. Once again, trying to make the stop and turn things over to their offensive unit, Phil.
Anytime you have a strong first half performance, what do you look for in the second half? You've got to be alert on the defensive side, look for something that's different, but more importantly, look for maybe a flea flicker, a double move by a wide receiver.
She would have picked that off.
Like this on the defensive side. The Giants have been awesome today.
I really wish she would have picked that off. If I could have gotten to Foles too, that would help.
The football picks up solid yards. Second and short. Boy, that's what every offense likes to be in.
Wow. Nice sideline catch.
That's reception number two for him.
Jim, when you're down multiple scores in the second half, you're looking for the little things to get momentum on your side.
Does this formation have my play?
First down. Don't look for the big plays. That was a good job by the offense that time.
Yes.
Foles is three for three with that.
See if this works. This is always my go-to pass stop play.
Back up the big play here. First down here after the completion.
Nice. Well, worked on that one.
Defense in the NFL when you can sack the quarterback without blitzing, and the defense did it that time.
Go for attempt number two.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Foles takes it from the gun. And they swap him again.
Got him again.
Well, you see it all the time.
The thing I like about playing the three-man deep is that normally I would run the man-up two-deep formation, but I'd always have problems with protecting the middle of the field, and always those long passes or anything cutting across the pass computer, cutting across the middle, the computer would always complete. Well, with the three-man deep, you're not playing prevent defense. Where, you know, they're not bumping or they're not staying as close to it. I'm just gonna let that bounce. But, you're not playing that, like, backed off prevent defense. You're still playing up close defense. But you've got that, third guy there in the middle playing zone to kind of help take away that middle of the field. It usually works most of the time. Like I said, I've had success when I need to shut down the pass attack from the computer in Draft Champions. I've had success running that play and shutting them down. This is what I just need to do right now. Turn on chew clock.
The chains after that last run. The play clock's running down. Gets the handle here.
So we'd like to maybe get two rounds of draft champions in today.
Over 60 yards.
So with the lead, I'm just gonna run the clock, try to get through these games as fast as possible. So we try to get two full rounds in.
Come to the line, trying to put together a scoring drive here in the fourth.
It's nice and convenient with the quarters being so short, too. That's kind of a thing I like about this. It's just like a short little draft, like fantasy draft, try to build the best team. And then it's kind of like quick kick games, only 3-minute quarters. So the games move by really quick. Peyton's gonna take overall, it's a lot of fun. If you haven't, for some reason, if you have Madden 16 and haven't tried Draft Champions, I would recommend it. It's a fun little kind of mini game mode.
To watch the game evolve around a running back, and man, this guy is taking advantage of those opportunities. Welcome back. Coming out of the 2-minute warning here in the final quarter. Breaking huddle at the 35.
Phone's going a little crazy there. Bunch of people liking the tweet of me being live and mad. And of course, putting in that it's 1-year anniversary.
Timeout called by the defensive unit.
People just liked it.
After that timeout by the defense, play is ready to resume. Down here after the run.
The first down here on the next play. Oh, it's going to be the next play.
Down after a gain of four.
Because they're, oh yeah, I got to get them to waste their timeouts too. Forgot I'm not up by the magic number of 17. It's a magic number in this game. I know I, back when I played Madden 15, I mentioned it a couple times. But yeah, 17 is the magic number in this game. If you're up by 17, then the computer won't call timeouts.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense. That's a gain of six. He's now past the 100-yard mark.
Whew. Well, that got me over the 100-yard mark for rushing.
They know once they get inside the red zone, they can run.
Sure, if I'm going to be able to
run the football.
No, I'm not.
Great job by the offensive line.
They try to pick up the first down here. Oh, stuffed. Good old classic fullback dive. It's all you, Hewitt.
This time to the fullback.
And that will be it. Now I can just take a QB kneel.
What a drive this has been.
And that's game number one in the books. Off to a good start with the shutout victory. I'll say so myself. Tick, tick, tick. Tick.
You're a quarterback.
Boom!
Points, but when you got to win in a low-scoring game, how did it feel?
Felt great because when you're the quarterback.
Yeah, mostly just the rushing tackle. Like I said, that's probably going to be my mentality in these games. It's not all that great of a receiving core, and having Walter Payton instead may just be more of a heavy, focused run attack. Reggie White again. Boy, they really want to let you know that you can get a bonus Reggie White by playing Ultimate Team this week. And we move up. We start at the top, go to the bottom, then move up one. Alright, here we go. Game two. Can we do it? That is the question. Hopefully. I mean, I think I have a decent enough defense to hold them down. Good enough offense to score and win games. At least I'm hoping. Campus Heroes. In fact, I have a Campus Hero. The Denard card I drafted, I believe, was a Campus Hero.
a successful start to the new campaign. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden Draft Champions.
I'm Larry Ridley. If you play the Gridiron Challenge, you'll come to hate me. Really, the Gridiron Challenge and the skills trainer in that, or the Gauntlet. In the training section. Oh, if you play that enough times, trying to get and beat level 25 to get the achievement, which I did in Madden 15, I've yet to do in this game. But man, Ridley gets annoying.
And with that kick, these two rivals are ready to go. Peyton's got it.
I should have held up a little bit. Let him get the block and then gone around. Doesn't help when you outrun your blockers.
Now an experienced quarterback with 4 years under his belt.
Well, you talk about Russell.
Nothing like a good old classic Green Bay and Chicago matchup here.
And he has an unbelievable throwing arm. You put those two things together.
Even though they're not, you don't worry about they're just randomly assorted guys.
Stopped by Jared Allen. This offensive line today will be
to protect
their quarterback as well as opening up some running lanes.
I hope they open up running lanes would be nice.
Peyton's got it on the handle.
That should be a first down.
41-yard line.
Okay, good.
Yeah, let's keep our eye on the defense. If they keep giving up runs like this, they're going to have to change what they're doing on the defensive side. Maybe bring another guy down in the box to stop those runs.
The Bears snap it at the 41. It's Kirby with the reception. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
Is he dead? Oh, nope, he's alive. We're good. I thought he died there for
when
a second.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver.
I mean, he kind of got squished there.
Probably in between some linebackers.
Setting up now at the
I think it was Madden 95 that had the ambulance that would come on the field when someone got hurt and would just run everybody. It's just cracking up. If you look it up, like Madden ambulance, I think it was 95 that had it. But if a player got injured, this ambulance would drive on the field to pick up the injured player. But if there were other players in the path of the ambulance, it just run everybody over. Oh, it was great.
He has the grab. Alexander's tackled down after a gain of 7.
No one got injured. I mean, the ambulance just kind of knocked them all out of the way, and they all got up.
Coming across the field, and it's a nice catch, just short of the first down.
Second down, 3 for the first.
But you would think that ambulance needed to fulfill a quota or something. There's one guy injured, but we need 5. Hit 4 more players as we drive onto the field.
Strong, you got to be tough, and we saw all those qualities that time in that run. Look at the broken tackles.
From the gun, Russell Wilson, ready for the snap. Makes the reception. The Bears now move the chains.
Alexander's kind of been a go-to target here.
And, you know, if you're on the defensive
finding
side,
those openings.
You don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive.
Ooh, if I get the right blocking, I'm right up the middle. Oh, no.
Bunkley's there to make the tackle.
Not a strong enough block.
The buck stops here. Jared Allen, always a force.
Yeah, it sure does. The big old cowboy can get it done. He knows how to pressure the quarterback and get him to the ground.
Jared Allen. Guy who retired only the way he could.
Defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. He'll go nickel. What a first series. Touchdown.
I loved his retirement announcement. It was just like typical Jared Allen fashion. If you haven't seen it, I'd go and watch it. He retires and then kind of rides off into the sunset, so to speak.
Good, smart drive.
He rides away from the camera on horseback. But if I remember right, I don't think there was a sunset at all.
Mason's got a chance to return this one. And he's had a
across the fumble. Fumble.
The Packers come to the line in a tight game here.
There's the classic Colt McCoy, draft champion opponent.
First down at the 21.
Toby Gerhart.
Only a yard or two.
Gerhart's trying to be patient.
I don't earn much of him anymore.
That time, and he only gets a short game.
Supposed to be the next big thing in Jacksonville. It turns out most of his success prior had just come because he was behind Adrian Peterson. I've seen, though, Trent Richardson's getting the second shot, or third shot. Third shot, I guess, at this point, with Baltimore.
First down at the 32.
Come here! Get him!
And that's Ruben in on the stop. Halftime is coming up, but first we reach the two-minute warning.
Ooh, four wide receivers. I think I know what I'm going to go with then.
All right, so now as we go back to the field, we've got a good game going, and an offense is trying to close the gap before halftime. McCoy's back in shotgun formation. Looking at every option.
You say, get him.
Now, looking at third down.
Always try to save the
would have loved for him to just throw it up so I could intercept it.
Let's go to the hurry up offense. Good job.
McCoy is going to take it from the gun. And it's swatted away.
Good try, though. Good try.
Packers really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third long. Of course, the defense is looking for passing.
A for effort.
They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Yeah, these games just, like, fly by. Like, I didn't realize it was already minute 33 left in the second quarter. Like I said, only three-minute quarters. They just kind of fly by quickly.
Peyton's got it from the nine.
Uh-oh.
Williams there that time for the tackle.
All right, minute 23.
About 12. Peyton's not necessarily displayed.
Three timeouts.
The dominant running game that we thought we might see today, but they're still in a comfortable position up on the board.
Well, they're winning.
We got plenty of time.
I'm not gonna just put all the blame on the offense. Let's give some credit to this defense. They are playing so well. They're not giving up any lanes for the running back to run into. Don't get brought down with arm tackles. That's what you teach everybody that carries a football in this league now. The wide receiver, excellent job
slot
breaking an arm tackle, getting the extra yards.
Wilson's 4 for 4 with that completion. First down and 10. He's got the catch. Alexander
call timeout there, save a little time.
A gain of 10. So they complete that one, yet it's still second down.
Let's see all these slot moves here.
Wilson standing back in the shotgun, ready for the
snap. Gosh.
Wilson's going to take off with it. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the
That's
field.
Exactly why I like having a mobile quarterback.
The Bears continue to look in one direction here in the first half.
What, like the band or the boy band?
The first half,
One Direction.
And he's helped his team big time.
All offenses, of course, they want to be balanced, but at this point, who cares? It's working so well. Throwing the football.
All right, single safety coverage unless he drops back.
Done, that's all that matters.
And now on first down, we'll go back to the air.
Oh!
Complete the hit, jarred the ball loose.
That was a big hit by the defender that time. The receiver.
I really don't have
football.
A really go up and get him possession receiver.
He goes over the middle, he'll be looking for that defender.
The Bears take it from the 43.
I should have put a little bit something more on that one.
If you're the defense, catch him by surprise and blitz.
I had him, and I just didn't put enough on that pass.
And he's thrown to the ground.
Oh, that was I went too much to four verticals. I should have gone with some shorter passing there. I may have just cost myself. I did cost myself. I'm gonna bother punt that away.
A good first half of action here, and soon
I should have tried one four vertical and then just a couple quick passes, gain a few more yards, get into field goal range. I don't have that. Like I said, not playing that much. I don't have any kind of awareness. Plus, if you go back and watch any of my old Madden streams, you'll see how stupid of a player I am, or can be.
I like what they did in the first half. The defense goes in there at halftime. They get a little rest, so come out here and show that energy and take advantage of the situation and make some plays.
I think I got to lock up the man defense.
Change, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You've got you're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team.
Well, if he wants to waste time off the clock, by all means, go ahead and waste it.
That he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
And it'll be second down and six after the running play on first down. McCoy's got it in the gun. Amaro with the reception.
Someone want to bring him down?
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches, running these short drag routes.
All right, come on now.
That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
From the gun.
All right, mix things up a little bit, I guess.
Ball spotted at the 49-yard line.
They're definitely going pass heavy here.
Second down and 10. The give.
James nice running play.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out.
A little pressure.
Nice job on the offensive line.
Out of the gun. Great pass. Great catch. Great control.
Wow.
First down here. They'll run it here. He's going to be tackled right around the 21-yard line.
I gave the computer. That's the thing. I think I don't know if they've ever boasted or if they've ever talked about it, but I think there's like a huge momentum aspect to this game.
Second down, four to go. He'll get it again.
Yeah. Okay.
Averaging about 4 yards a carry. This will be the eighth play of this drive.
Yeah, I feel there is a huge momentum aspect to this game. Is when you screw up, suddenly the computer, you can't call the right play against the computer. It always has an answer.
Failing to complete that one, so second down here. The Packers with an empty backfield look here. He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Jason Morrow makes the
good
catch.
Good stop. At least make a goal line stand here and hold him to field goal. That would be great.
It's been all about the defenses today as we welcome you back to the action. This has been a long drive so far. This is a time where the quarterback has to manage the clock, has to be very careful. Trailing, needing points to get back into this one.
Nice stop. Beautiful. Alright, little bend, but don't break defense there.
kick is good.
And I know you probably noticed Eli Manning there on the field. That's what happens with the computers. They'll have good quarterbacks and good players on their roster. They just won't use them. It'll just the way it's formatted, they'll use weaker players.
What were you doing? You should have went for it and try to find a way to get 7 points instead of kicking for three. Peyton's going to test the coverage this time.
Oh, that would have been great if I could have split that gap and returned this for a touchdown.
Before he's taken down.
That would have put the seal on this game.
The Bears have been in a fight today. The score's 7-3. Well, as the clock is winding down, the offense would like to just run it out.
Keep chugging, Peyton, go!
The Bears really got it going.
A couple of low scoring games. You can tell I definitely don't have that strong of a pass attack.
And that first down, what does it do? It just gives the offensive coordinator confidence. And of course, this quarterback, he is always ready to go.
2 minute warning here.
In the second half.
Love to at least get into field goal range to make it a 7-point game.
2 minutes remaining in this nail biter. Can the offense hold on to the football and run out the clock? Peyton's taking the handoff.
Of course, I would love to just break off a long touchdown too, and put this game completely out of reach.
Second down here after that run play.
Minimum goal is field goal.
They bring in the extra tight end. Peyton's handing the football. Brought down at the 41-yard line. No surprise, they immediately call the timeout. At the line of scrimmage.
Still finding the gaps here in the run game.
First and 10. Staying with the running game on first down. Peyton's tackled down at the 32. And they're going to call the timeout here to stop the clock. Second down coming up. The Bears line up, split backfield. Ball's going to take the handoff now. Picks up.
I like that play. Here. Seen some good success. Two times I've run it. Because I'm always a great, I always love the 0-1 trap.
Offense has three more chances. Now first and 10. Back to him.
You can't bring me down.
Rushing on the day. The defense got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is.
I know I probably shouldn't be doing this. I probably should just kneel and run the clock out.
Peyton's going to secure the handoff. And gains maybe four. This will be second down.
Why not try to score a little bit? Although I probably should have just gone back to the huddle so I could have wasted the clock. And waste it the old-fashioned way. Chew clock is one of my favorite things they put into last year's game. I'm glad they kept it this year.
Second and goal from the three. And it's good.
Just to me, it functions a whole lot better. I mean, the accelerated clock is nice and that, but when it came to under 2 minutes, the accelerated clock stopped working. It wouldn't do the acceleration at the 2 minute warning marks. But with the chew clock, you're able to run more time off the clock. It actually does do the acceleration.
Mason's got it on the return. That return's good for about 21. The Bears defense comes out here in the last
man up three deep.
What a satisfying feeling this has to be for them right now, Phil. They know they've got victory in their grasp.
It was a day of domination, Jim. The way they played, the energy they had, the game plan was awesome. They executed very well. And that's how they got the win.
And there's your ball game. I got an extra touchdown in there. A little more life to the scoreboard.
So long for now.
Oh, wow, I almost doubled my yards through the air on the ground. That made a lick of sense. I'm not sure it did. Almost had double amount of yards on the ground that I had through the air. That's probably a... probably the better way to say that. Alright, here we go. Third game. All comes down to this.
Dreams of a title could be about to come to fruition. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions. The Bears have run right through these first couple games, but as the
the Patriots.
The competition gets tougher. They'll square off here against the New England Patriots.
The Patriots. Grimes, McCourty, Sherman. Chung.
The Bears are back deep. Waiting for the kick.
Already some good players there on, just on the kickoff team.
And with that kick, we're underway. Peyton's got it.
Oh! Here he goes! Come on! Come on! Come on! Come on! Ah! Oh! So close. I should have tried to spin move back to the middle. So close, Etsy. Right there, I should have tried to spin move.
Wilson's heading out now for his first series.
But that's okay.
Well, this early
that's right. He'd be resting. Long kickoff return.
This keeps the defense. They might be shaking a little, but if they stop them here to a field goal try or worse, that'll get their confidence back.
Here's a look at the offensive unit that needs to get off to a strong start today.
He's not going to be on the field. I've wanted to get him the touchdown.
Second and goal from the three.
No one trap doesn't really work against goal line defense. Should have known that.
For a touchdown, I'll tell you what, that'll give him some second downs.
Third and goal from the four. Throws the pass.
Touchdown.
Touchdown.
Well, there's a fun start to this game. A long kickoff return, near kickoff return touchdown.
And with that touchdown,
and cap it off. With a passing attack. Okay, I like that start. I can live with this start. Now, the question is, can I get a good defensive start? That remains a good question. Feely. Crush him. Oh, never mind.
And this will be coming out to the 20 as he thinks better.
Crush him! Kill him!
He was the first overall
selection Cam Newton.
Of the 2011 draft. Out of all
not exactly
quarterback Cam Newton.
Quarterback I want
to
see there.
The
well, I love having a mobile quarterback. I hate playing against a mobile quarterback.
What a career he's had so far.
All right, I want to check out what I'm even dealing with here. All right, Newton. Oh, yeah, see, why don't you start Jimmy Garoppolo? Jimmy Hill, Sherman, Cruz, Roddy White, Andre Johnson, Sammy Watkins, Sean Jackson. Okay. That's glitch. there. I've seen that happen before. It'll be mostly Vernon Davis in that spot. Okay, pretty decent offensive line. Let's see, Campbell's a Johnson defense. We got in the middle. Williams and Williams. Okay. Doomerville, Mosley, Levy, Skandrick, Grimes, Smith, Hall, Cordy, Warren. This is pretty basic defensive team for them. Always seem to see McCourty and Ward in the final round.
First down at the 20. Newton off the mark that time. For this offense, one of the most consistent threats they've had since being a first-round pick in 2005 out of UAB is Roddy White.
Yeah, he's an all-around player, Roddy White. He is
throw a little zone here, Adam. I guess Marcell Reese is going to be starting. Last time I saw that happen, he was still starting at fullback.
Hill's got it. Counter run.
But he was also listed as the top tight end for some reason. Of course, they could have been running a tight end in the backfield.
Is Justin Tuck.
Set as well. That should be interesting, having Marcell Reese out there as a tight end. See how that works out for him.
Inside on the defensive line.
The pass ball's incomplete, and they fail to pick up.
Okay, good defensive start.
And it'll be Ryan back to punt.
Now, can I get a lengthy punt return?
Peyton's going to take this one from the 30.
Nope.
He's brought down right around the 43-yard line. That return's good for about 13.
All right.
The Patriots couldn't stop the pass.
See, okay, Peyton's back in. Time to do some damage on the ground. Maybe we can get him the touchdown he deserves.
The defensive calls were good. The techniques and the execution was awful. Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Hand off made.
Oh, I should have just cut to the right. I made a mistake. I saw that big hole there in the middle of the field.
DeAndre Levy.
Well, if you close your eyes and you're watching this defense and you hear somebody makes a tackle.
What is, wait, is it Levy?
Be Levy because he
I thought it was Levy.
Everywhere.
Man, huh. He is as a always get his name messed up.
Stop.
Peyton's able to get it done that time. Why?
Yes, it is Levy. I think I always just said Levy. I know that was wrong.
Third short, he just gets it done for sheer willpower.
Whoa! I asked it there then. Heh! Excuse me while I walk through you.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness,
boom!
No doubt. When you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Okay, you know what? I think instead of doing this, I'm just going to let the quarter come to an end.
The Bears still possess the football as we begin the second quarter.
I'm gonna try slots out.
Right around 3 minutes remaining before halftime.
Not sure how successful this is gonna be.
Now is gonna go nickel, and the second quarter is underway with this.
Ah, fine, Peyton. Ooh, I might have had Randall Cobb there deep.
When you're a quarterback throwing against zone defenses, look for the open space. That's what he did that time. He found it, and the receiver ran in there and made the catch.
Press coverage here.
The Bears take it from the 28.
Makes not the really anything there.
You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind?
Back to the ground game.
Keep going full speed.
Uh-oh.
A good receiver.
Wilson's 3-for-3.
They were ready for the ground game.
Peyton. A dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
I'll let the 2-minute warning hit. Let me try some play action here. I haven't really run any play action in this game. Plenty of running plays.
The 2-minute warning in this one.
all leading up to this one great play action play. Let's see if I have anything here in the suggestions. Nope. Concept.
Defense out on that field, trying to stand tall and keep this deficit as it is on the scoreboard.
Play time. That's what we need. Play action. Oh, I'm not going to have time. I'm going to have to call timeout here.
The Bears will take a second here to talk things over as they call a timeout on second down. And now they'll try
Let's
over
go with this one.
On second down. The Bears come out. Jumbo package on the field. Wilson's now going to leave the pocket.
And there's Paul wide open for the touchdown. All that running paid off.
Tight ends are a position where you got to be able to do it all. You got to be able to block, run routes, and you got to be able to get in position so you have a chance to catch the touchdown.
I think they are going
to
get a running into the kicker penalty or roughing the kicker. One of the two. They got roughing the kicker. Oh, that's great.
Personal foul, late hit on the kicker, and that will be a 15-yarder. Jim,
hey, I'm going to kick a field goal here. I get 3 points for this.
A situation like this. Football teams
it's up.
This every single
it's
day.
Good.
That's what they work on from the start of training camp. Such a big mistake. We'll see if it comes back to haunt.
Jamal Charles readying himself for this next possession. He's got to be hoping things improve for him on this drive because up to this point, it has not been one of his better days.
Well, he's the star of the football team.
Jamal Charles hasn't even played, so that would be a reason why he hasn't had a good day.
They're losing, so find a way to get him more involved. Maybe throw him a pass if that's what it takes, but get this offense and especially this one game rolling. Good job of hurrying up and getting on that football and trying to get the play off. Don't you...
Oh! Richard Sherman! Can't throw against him.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the
What are you thinking, Cam?
And they made the interception.
The Bears offense ready to continue its recent run here as they've scored the last two times they've had it, Phil.
Well, let's look at it from the defensive side. What do you think they're thinking? Oh, my gosh, what's coming next? Because everything the offense has tried so far.
Bounce to the outside instead.
6 yards a carry on the day.
Nice job that time by the runner. Gets out of bounds after the
try
play.
Try a little pass
you got
play here.
2 minutes and you need to stop the clock, so he gets it done.
The Patriots lined up in the nickel, takes the snap. We're about midway, second quarter.
Whee!
That's another reception. Give him two.
That was fun. Do it again.
Big pass plays in the NFL, play cover four. But what it doesn't stop is these short passes underneath.
Wilson's 5 for 5 after that completion.
I just juking all over the place on that one. I had no idea where I was actually going to go.
And are left now with only one. Second and 8 coming up. The Bears are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. The catch is made by Randall Cobb. The Bears get a first down. First down coming up. They're going to the hurry up. Back to the line. They'll go ground.
Oh, and there's the touchdown Peyton deserves. I knew I'd eventually get it for him.
And this game gets more and more out of hand. The second half may just end up being a mere formality.
It could be. You know, you go in at halftime in a game like this when you're really getting manhandled, and you got to find a way just to make a few plays to give you hope. If you can do that, look, in this league, you never know.
Jackson's going to test the coverage here. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Patriots just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold them this time, Phil, because we know how crucial
it is. We're not going to let them try not to give up anything.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right?
It's the biggest offensive output I've had thus far. I like it when it comes in the third game when it all matters. It's all on the line.
The Bears with a nickel look here on defense. The Patriots from the 27. Jeremy Hill has the catch. The Patriots.
I almost got him.
Timeout remaining.
I'm going to go for a Hail Mary here. Really wouldn't surprise me. So I'm going to man up three deep.
Newton's going to be in the pistol.
It trips bunch. Oh, nope, they're going to run it.
Gets about nine on the play. They're able to move the chains.
Now they may try.
Time for the hurry.
Go for deep pass.
Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab. And there's a timeout, so we'll take one with them. You're watching the NFL on EA.
Okay, giving up a few yards here. Now they're out of timeout, so I'm going to guess this is the Hail Mary pass. Or just throw it short.
It's wide open.
Ah, tackle him inbounds. Woof!
We come to the half, and this game isn't even close. Time to get some backups, some playing time, and keep your starters healthy.
I think I'll leave my starters in.
And no return here, so Newton will start.
Crazy things can happen.
The Bears' defense, Phil, has been the story of this game.
Him, so few words. That's
it is. This is the story of a defense.
What's going on? But you're right. They've been dominating physically, just getting it done. And if they keep this up, there's no way the other team's going to win.
White takes the hit and brought down.
Boo.
Show off the footwork. Wow.
Boo.
What a good job. Those feet, like a dancer, gets himself in very good position to throw the football.
The Patriots will take the snap from the 35.
Somebody stop him.
At the 37.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stop him for a short game.
The Bears defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Second down and nine. Hill's handed the ball.
Oh, no. Don't let him go. McCourty, I had him.
Line of scrimmage and a loss of one.
The Patriots offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play. But what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job by the offensive line.
Newton's back in shotgun formation. And it's complete over to Cruz. Mark him down for another
too far
reception.
Back
Patriots on their
on the zone. I probably should have changed that.
Third and long situations, but that is a really nice job that time by the offense, the quarterback. They pick up the first down. That'll get you going.
That'll also get you going there, too. Just trying to remember how to change. Oh, there we go. I probably should change it to hooks, maybe.
Shotgun formation. Had it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
Nope. Thank you. Try again.
The Patriots come to the line with a bunch set. Third and 12.
Come here, Newton.
The offense was able to recover the ball.
It's a shame no one got there for the fumble recovery, but
John Ryan will
the
be
fumble, nonetheless,
the
I mean,
field.
It stops their drive completely.
Peyton's got it at the 13. Gaines, 15.
The Bears know there's three parts to every football game. Offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return. Good blocking. They get it done.
The Bears are looking to build on a
now
touchdown
it's time to
it
march to victory.
With their offense.
They had tremendous rhythm, Jim, on the offensive side. Another
and by march to victory, I mean run the clock out.
The football. They're guessing run. And the offense threw it. That's what
I clicked too fast.
Do.
I got a little trigger happy there. I didn't get the chance to turn chew clock on.
Take advantage of that.
They need to get the playoff.
No, we don't.
The Bears are still in possession as we get this final quarter underway. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter.
Oh, no.
After picking up only a yard.
He's averaging
only
2 yards
per
carry on the day.
Got to get a first down.
Last carry, it's third and three. The Patriots
wipe the rest of this clock out.
Go nickel from the shotgun. Secures it with two hands.
That'll do the job.
Beyond the markers, it's a first down.
Well, at least for now, it'll do the job. It'll give me a two-minute warning.
They've got a big lead. It's not about scoring anymore. It's just about milking that clock. And that is an art.
Milking the clock like it's a cow.
Completed his last seven passes. Peyton's lined up as the single back. Brought down by Dumerville.
Peyton's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
The Bears will take the snap from the 45, and there's only 2 yards to be found right there.
Coming up strong here on the defensive end.
After that last run, it sets up third and six. Peyton's gonna take the
nope.
Needing five to move the chains.
Should have gone with just the straight fake punt pass.
Lined up in the nickel. Three-step drop. Jeremy Curley.
Hang on to it, Curley. There's the game.
Here they come to the 41.
2-1. Victory.
Phil, before we go, how about
for mediocre defense was good, and the running game was good.
You didn't have to
for mediocre
yourself,
pass team,
you feel good, and you just
not too bad at all.
For Phil Simms and all the crew,
just got some good offensive explosions in this one. Two shutouts too. Man, said a lot of that had to do with that defense. Oh, that's a successful for round one, and looking at the clock, yeah, I figured we'd probably be able to get two in, just with the shortness of the quarters in the games. Go ahead and advance. We'll redeem an ultimate team, and maybe at the end we'll open the two packs. Now we'll just jump into second to one. So here we go. Round two. Let's see what kind of team we can build here. Ooh. Multiple offense, multiple defense. Oh, man. This is a tricky one because I really love Patriots pass playbook, but looks like they use pretty much the same thing, so I'm going to go with Fisher, get that boost to the run game. Well, Jameis Winston's my quarterback. I can actually live with that.
Way to go in this draft, but if you can lock up a few key
wow,
here,
already good selection
picks,
here.
It's a great luxury to
yeah, I think I'll shore up the center of my line with Mangold.
And a good one it is. You get a 6-time Pro Bowl selection up
front. Oh, Terrell Pryor.
Line calls from the center position, and he will be a great addition to this offensive unit.
All right, I'm going to build the offensive line.
A huge impact over what was there before.
Oh, of course then I get Eric Wood. All right, well, in this case, I already got a pretty strong center. I'm going to take get a decent defensive back in there.
A superstar or two. And this guy right here certainly fits that billing.
So what we got here. Whoa. Play. That's actually not that bad. I might. Kind of comparing what I have here.
Yeah, this
I'll take Webb here.
One, if you ask me, the talent's certainly there. I'm just not sure that we'll see the best of him in a system like this.
All right, we'll go Jared Cook. A solid receiving tight end there. And, of course, get Antonio Gates in the next round. I need a wide receiver, so I'll pick up Matthews here.
Or do you just try to cover as many areas of the field as possible? This is a pretty telling pick here. Do you go for a big bruiser up front or get yourself someone who could be a difference maker at a skill position? Now that is quite a threesome.
Wow.
Every round we're this well stocked. And this is a big
My offensive line is gonna be beast.
Maybe a no-brainer, but a great pick regardless.
I think I gotta take the best player on the board there in Mosley.
Boy, it's finger crossing time now. With the end in sight and a few more holes to fill. You've got to be hoping that there's still a gem or two that becomes available. Not much second guessing needed for that pick. He'll align perfectly with what this team's trying to do.
Ooh, Glover Quinn. All right.
A good pick there at the free safety spot. Glover Quinn of the Lions, the NFL's leader in interceptions last season with 7. And that distinction helped earn him an invite to his first ever Pro Bowl as well.
All right. Yeah, Donald, get some NFL's power in the middle there.
The year last year with the Rams is the pick here. He's a disruptor from his defensive tackle position, and he'll fit in nicely here.
Yeah, sure.
A bit of a dilemma with this threesome. Which side of the ball do you turn your focus to here?
Defensive backs are okay. Could use another one. I'll go with Floyd. Take a risk, see what I get in the Legends round.
These are tough decisions here. Offense or defense? Which side has the more pressing need?
I guess I'll go with Peyton again.
And I think that pick comes to the surprise of nobody. You had to figure
that out. All right, well, this is going to be an interesting one. Don't have as strong as a pass defense as I did in the last one. But I've actually got a pretty decent line and offense. I mean, pass rush there. Oh, I do have Johnson, though. I'm going to switch Brock in there. Butler, number 4. I think I can do some damage with this team. Got my mobile quarterback already. offensive line, other than Brewer, really. It's the weakest one. And pass blocking's a little weak. That's all right. Wide receivers didn't really get that strong of a choice again. That's what I like about this, is you never know how you're going to build your team, what you're going to be able to get or not. But it's got some strong 90 overall players on defense, so. Maybe story of defense again. Really, it's not going to matter too much in the first. It's really going to come down to being able to stop them in that last game. Oh, I always cover the ball when I'm running up through the middle.
A new era begins today. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions.
Here we come. Here we go. We're going to rock.
They've got and how or if these pieces are going to fit together. Their opponents in this one, the Minnesota Vikings.
Don't ask me why I start singing Black Eyed Peas.
Randy Bullock looks set now.
I have no idea what I do half the time, why I even do it. I don't know. See, I have no idea why I did that. Ah, Bullock.
For the kick.
Bullock. I like this setup better. I always like receiving the ball. I like getting off to a fast start and setting the pace, but I also love having the ball after halftime. Always love starting the second half.
Coming out to the 20. At quarterback, out of TCU.
Andy Dalton.
Second round pick and Rose Bowl winner, Andy Dalton.
Andy Dalton, this team loves his leadership skills.
Yeah, every once in a while, they throw in an Andy Dalton.
And to top it all off, a really good leader.
First down at the 20.
Oh, this is going to be fun.
This might not be nice to see, but every once in a while it's kind of fun to watch the quarterback get sacked like that. Good job by the defensive end.
Like, who? Why is 32 in the middle there? I realize it's campus hero, Mosley, of course. He's going to be wearing his college jersey number. Bring him down!
The Vikings running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards.
Donald in the middle. Yeah, this is going to be a decent defensive line. Whew, nice deflection there.
The Vikings put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the
good
third and long.
First defensive. Possession.
Peyton's got a chance this time.
I lost the word.
The middle of the field at the 50. That return's good for about 8. Starting at quarterback.
Serious.
Florida State.
I knew it would come to me.
Trophy winner, Jameis Winston.
Yes, listen, he deserved to be the first pick of the draft, and you say the future, the franchise.
Good first defensive series. That's what I was looking for.
They are hoping you are right because they pinned all their hopes on Jameis Winston.
First down at the 50.
Oops! I did not wait long enough for him to go past.
So talented. They can just do everything. They're strong enough to stop the run, but how about this interception? Good job. Good reading of the quarterback and a nice catch.
Strong eye, handoff.
That was a gift I just gave them.
He is expected to carry a lot of the load today out of the backfield. Terrence West.
Well, in 2014, a lot of people loved him a lot as a sneaky pick in the NFL draft. And we saw why in 2014. Had an excellent year, an excellent running back.
Has his man. That's his first reception today.
Well, if you guard the tight end close, it sometimes that doesn't matter. They're so big and they got long arms, they can still make the catch. Quarterbacks give them a chance, they get it done.
The Vikings take it from the 43. That's a gain of 8.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it.
Okay. Now.
Second down and 2.
There we go. Good blitz.
Quarterback was not alert that time. The corner comes on the blitz, gets to the quarterback, and takes him down.
At the line of scrimmage, the 41. Third down and 8.
Oh, Dalton. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh. Oh. I'm not sorry. Who am I kidding? Eddie, and boom! Oh, he walked right into it, too. That was the best part about that. Please kill me.
They're set to punt it away now.
Ah, that was a hit.
We are deadlocked right now in a game that has seen its fair
share. Steps up to throw, steps into the hit.
Watch, isn't it? I love defenses when they come out and they just.
All right, let's see if I can do a little better now. Offense up. That's what offensive so side.
Far, and I think it's going to continue.
A little rough start, but okay.
We'll
overcome
the
this. And then, of course, the just start by going on the ground to Peyton.
Yeah, the defense, look, they got good players, and you know you give them enough chances.
That worked out well.
The play, you have to be careful with the football. The offense was not, and that's why.
Got the strong. What do you think they're talking offensive about line. Let's put it to the test.
They're probably telling the quarterback if you do that again, they're going to take you out. I don't know, but
see how good it really is.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it
just
opens
get
up
that
so many
one
things for
big
you
gap.
They want to
nope, not there.
Peyton's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
And now we reach the 2-minute warning here in the second quarter. Welcome back. Halftime just a couple of minutes away as we resume play out of the 2-minute warning. The Bears from the 37. Looking across the middle. Locked in on the football and has hold of it.
There we go. Hands.
This guy knows
this
how
opening
to
there.
Rack up the rack yards, doesn't he?
He does.
I don't know if this is going to be a good idea.
He's able to catch the football.
This is a bad idea. I know this is a bad idea. Yep, I'm going to bail out of this bad idea. It's okay. I fumbled out of bounds. We're all good.
After nearly turning it over, it's second down.
We're all good. All good. All good.
Nickel look here on defense. Midway, second quarter.
I should have had a touchdown on that one.
Very smart runner. He knows
I was expecting to come firing out through the line like that.
Yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
The Bears at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. To Williams.
Yes!
Brings it in for the score in the end zone.
Woo!
What a throw by the quarterback for a touchdown. It was just really nice.
Nice, easy two-point conversion.
Right on target. Touchdown.
The Bears ready to kick it away.
And here's the kick. Oh, I'm going to get you. gonna get you, get you, get you, get you. Here I come. Here I come. Oh! Taken down right at about the 29, babbin.
Not quite to the 30.
Babbity babbin.
The Vikings have put
all right, Dalton, I'll try to
really
have a little mercy on you.
Today.
Oh, there's that hit again!
To stay upright and make the plays, but it's tough to do so when you're constantly being hit.
Yeah, no matter what you do as a quarterback, though, you
he's just getting crushed in this game.
You have to keep your focus down the field.
In fact, let's try to crush him here. Throw a little blitz at him to start this series.
Dalton's alone in the backfield. The Vikings have it at the 29.
Just hear him let out a little scream. Throws that one away.
The Bears will
please don't hurt me.
Second and 10.
Oh,
pulls it in. That's a tackle. 48.
I came through. I was expecting to come through there with a little bit of a block. I came through untouched off the line. I hit X to make the move on the offensive lineman. Of course, I wasn't locked in.
Dalton will take it from the gun. Reaches out and grabs it. He'll pick up 7 this time. After the pass play, gain 7.
Well, oops.
Second and 3 on the way. Dalton's going to take it from the gun. Gets it out for the completion.
Hey, Fumblecroft.
I don't know what the answer is when it comes to guarding these tight ends now. There's just not much you can do. I'll tell you the best way to stop the tight end, rush the quarterback.
First down at the 30.
Here I come, Dalton.
Good job by the offense here. Hustle up, get that football snap, conserve time, and most of all, conserve that timeout. Those are
here I come again!
He's going down again.
What is that, third sack of the game now for him?
It
was Crawford, I think.
Third down after the sack.
Third or fourth?
The Vikings will set
I've lost track at this point.
Is the first down line. Dalton from the shotgun stands in the pocket.
Oh, come here one more time. Fourth and 42. Wow.
We've reached the intermission, and soon we'll be sending you to Larry Ridley.
All right, let me. I'm just curious to see how many that is now. See here. 3.5 sacks now for Jack Crawford.
Breakdown all the first half highlights as we send it to Orlando in a moment. You're watching the NFL.
Poor Andy Dalton.
Peyton's going to run this one out.
Whoop.
And he's tackled.
Okay, well,
3 yards away
going backwards a little bit there.
The Bears offense takes the field. Let's see if this momentum can carry over from the first half because they have been brilliant to this point, partner.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've
done. A little stop juke there. Kind of worked for a second.
The defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half. That's a nice play that time by the offense, getting the first down. They're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That is a great feeling.
And the give to Sean Green.
Time for a little Sean Green action.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no
shoulders tightening up there a little bit.
And try to throw the football down. The quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. It's a 2 tight end formation. Sean Green.
No, I should have cut back to the middle there.
Loss.
The Bears offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens?
Maybe not the play I wanted to go with.
The Bears come to the line. First down marker at the 40.
quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Oh, no. Oh, I had him.
The Bears don't have a lot of options.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well,
situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up.
I made the wrong play call there on that. That run.
And the punt is kicked out of bounds.
Defense can continue to hold up here.
Looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Dalton's ready for the snap, empty backfield. Dalton standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. On the money.
Drop it!
That's his first reception today. Down to a minute to go in the third quarter, and a first down play coming up.
Man, I cannot let them score.
First down at the 39. Here's the handoff out of the strong arm.
So much for that.
He'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
Come on, defense. Remember when I was saying something about the momentum aspect of this game? This is what I'm talking about right here.
Dalton will be taking this snap out of the pistol.
Come here, Dalton.
And it's just thrown.
Just couldn't get him.
Second down and 10. Hand off. Brought down at the 47-yard line.
All right, just need one stop here. One stop.
The defense looking for one more stop here on third down after that.
That's what I just said.
The Vikings offense tries to continue some momentum, still possessing the football as the final quarter gets underway. These guys need to make something happen on offense, with time beginning to run out. Here is the first snap of the final quarter. Reaches out.
Oh, is that enough?
Good job by the defense. Staying in the right spots. They give up the short
pass.
Oh,
of course they're going to go for it.
And now we have fourth down coming up.
Time and this one's running out, and the defense knows it needs another stop. The Vikings have it at the 39.
Yes!
The ball over on
oh, thank
here
you.
We are in the fourth quarter field.
There's that strong
and they
defense.
The defense to step up and make a stop on fourth down, and they deliver the goods.
Boy, did they get it done. That's what they did. Stop them on fourth down. Now, let's see if this offense can go
now,
out there.
See if I can get the momentum
away.
Back here.
It's now second down. We're late in the fourth, and the offense is just trying to sit on the lead. Right in on the tackle.
All right, well, that gets me to the two-minute warning.
The Bears' offense has been tough today.
Put two clock on here.
That's a nice job picking up that first down. It's been fun to watch. They got a small lead here in the second half. We'll see if that first down can lead them to a score.
Love to get into field goal range right here.
He's averaging right around 7 yards per carry on the game. Set up now at the 42. Second down and 8. Takes another handoff. Ball is out.
Oh no!
Going back the other way. Here we are in the last 2 minutes, and they fumble the football. Before there's another snap, the officials want to go back and take a look at that last one.
Oh, I think the ground caused
it. So they're looking to see if the ball came out before the knee was down.
I think the ground caused it. I think I'm going to catch a break
here.
It's
pretty easy to determine. Jim, you know, it's just always a clear shot. When that knee hits the ground,
come on, please. Overturned.
If it's a fumble or down by contact.
Well, it was called one way on.
Puts me at what, third and nine? So
it was a booth review, and the call was overturned.
I think if you left it up to the coaches, they'd like the booth to review them all, Jim, because put all the pressure on the officials in the NFL. That's what it's there for, to overturn bad calls on the field.
The Bears come out in a jumbo set. The Bears take it from the 43.
Oh,
the mark there, incomplete.
You have a lead in the fourth quarter. You got the football. You want to keep it. Not a very good play call there. So now it's up to your defense to try to stop and win the game.
Ow. I just don't have much going offensively. Ooh, that's going to be a good punt, though.
That punt sets up the defense.
Ooh.
Excellent position.
Good pin punt, though.
Inside the 10. A look at Glover Quinn right there. And it looks like this defense could more or less wrap up the game if they can get another big stop right here, partner.
Jim, I'd love to get a sack, but they're probably going to call a run play here.
In other words, you can't worry about, oh, if we do something wrong, we're going to lose. No, don't think that way. Be positive.
Yeah, get a few yards there.
Second down, late in the fourth quarter.
You know, you go with the hurry-up offense so you can get a high number of plays in.
Ooh! Again, expect. I gotta stop hitting X automatically, thinking I'm gonna get locked up into, or locked up with the offensive lineman.
The Vikings will look to get to the 13 to pick up a first. Third and seven. Airing it out.
Nope, that's incomplete.
This is going out of bounds. Incomplete.
All right. Man up three deep.
They're going for it on fourth down. Andy Dalton in the shotgun formation. Brings it in.
Oh, what a catch.
That's another reception, giving him two.
And just a half a second away from coming up with the safety.
Every snap crucial the rest of the way.
Come here. All right. Well, at least I managed to chase him into Hughes.
Second down coming up. Time, obviously, a factor the rest of the way.
Managing that clock, such a big deal in the NFL. That's why they're hurrying up. Don't use that timeout. Keep those.
Whoa, what a one-handed grab. All right. I'll give props to the computer for that one.
So big at this point. Won't huddle now. Gonna conserve the timeout and rush back to the line. The Vikings snap it at the 36.
Nope. Oh, he got it away.
It's fourth down, and there is
may
no
just
other
run it here
than to go for it. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field.
But I don't trust them.
The Vikings snap it at the 36.
Oh, they did go with just the run play. That's okay. It's going to waste time off the clock.
On every snap now. Traylon, they'll go hurry up rather than call the timeout.
Oh, this game's going right down to the wire.
Every play is huge now. Second down on the way.
Going for a couple Hail Marys here.
The Vikings take it from the 43.
Oh, a diving pick by Butler.
What a horrible time to throw the interception. But
wow,
to the
nice
here,
kick
Phil.
On the ground. Let's see that. Oh, hits someone right in the hands there. And then, oh yeah, get a nice angle of that. And somehow makes the interception there. Magnet hands.
Stop the play, the takeaway at just.
But I'll take it. Wow. Oh, that's right. I forgot they still had a timeout left.
Situation like this. You know, they took advantage of a quarterback who they knew was going to have to take a chance, and they were ready to pounce on it.
Takes the knee. This was a hard-fought win out there for one side today. Not much scoring going on, but doesn't matter. It's a W.
Yeah, it sure is. Hey, listen, Oof. That was fun to watch. When you see a low-scoring game now in the NFL, it means, well, we had some hard hitting. It was hard fought.
Okay, well,
fun to watch.
That was an interesting one.
So for Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.
That was only game one. All right, let's hope game two goes a little bit better. Okay. I hope the defense can keep playing at that level. Offense, I need to get better offensively with this team.
The Bears got the season off on the right foot, but they definitely still have room for improvement as they take the field for the second time. Their opponents here will be the Indianapolis Colts.
Indy Colts.
And Randy Bullock looks ready to get this one underway. The Colts are ready to run back this kick.
Bow, 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 bow.
Mason's gonna take a knee, so this will come out to the 20. He emerged as a star.
RG3.
Baylor went on to win the Heisman and come into the league as a first-round pick, quarterback Robert Griffin III.
I think when you talk about Robert Griffin III, you're going to see a quarterback who's going to finally mature. He understands the NFL now after his first 3 years in the league. It's been rough.
Got some stars on the right side here.
And the speed to do.
Whoop. Come here, Starks.
And Starks is tackled down at the 24. Here's a look at the offense. The sure hand in Brian Hartline starts at wide receiver.
Jim, you and I talk about this guy every single year. Does not get the credit he deserves. Just a solid wide receiver who's extremely productive and stays on the field. He is a good player.
The Colts take it from the 23. Will go ground. Setting now the defensive unit. Check out at cornerback, former third-round pick in 2009 out of Nichols State, Ladarius Webb.
Yeah, Webb is one of those corners that can just
goes from a 91 to 79.
Defense because yeah. You can see him just go cover that guy one-on-one all day long, and we'll do some other stuff to help our defense.
Switch a little cover two man here.
The Colts snap it up at the 26. Incomplete, looking underneath that time.
Did they just deflect their own pass? It looked like just what
no chance of making it.
Whoever that was. Let's see, who was that here? Number 14. It was Brown. Oh, yeah. He kind of once he gets off a little bit of a screen there, he blocks it with his helmet. Boink! 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 Well, thanks for the pass defense assist.
The Colts are set to punt.
They're set to punt, but they're not punting.
Peyton's got it now.
keeps his legs moving. Peyton's tackled down after a gain of 10. And a run back of about 10. Winston's coming out now at quarterback for the Bears.
No doubt about it. At Florida State, he showed everybody, he showed me, that he is an NFL thrower of the football. He's accurate, not afraid to...
He showed me the way of the monkey. The Mung King. All hail the Mung King.
First down at the 36. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
That time the quarterback throws the drag route. It doesn't get a first down, but still it's a good...
Yeah, that's okay. It got 9 yards.
Right on target, and it picked up solid yards.
The Bears will take the snap from the 45.
Excuse me, coming through. Beep, beep, honk, honk.
Peyton's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he?
It's up.
First down. Now your offense has three more chances.
Shot out of there.
Peyton's in the backfield. Single back set. Here's the handoff. Ends up picking up 3 yards. Now, as we highlight the offensive unit, Jared Cook is one of the biggest targets you will find in this league.
Yes, he is. Boy, when you're tall and fast and you play the tight end position, there are a lot of ways you can get the football to him. And Jared Cook, one of the best in the NFL.
I waited too long on the release.
This defensive lineup is anchored by the 340-pound presence of defensive lineman Paul Solei.
6'4", 340 pounds. And I'm telling you, you look at him, you think, oh, he weighs about 280 pounds. That's how in shape he is. Every defense needs inside presence, and Paul Solei will give it to you.
There we go.
Pass is thrown to Jordan Matthews.
That ball moving.
About the play action pass game, it's really when you call it. You got to be in a situation where the defense is thinking run, and when they are,
good field goal position now.
Or I should say, the smarts, the fake.
Even better field goal position.
Good call that time by the.
But you know what? Let's get a touchdown.
Heading to the line at the 22.
I like touchdowns more. More points. In case you forgot how the game of football works.
He's gonna get another carry. Picks up. Here, the Bears' offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway.
Just keep pounding.
The second quarter is underway with this snap, and that's Solei in on the stop.
Peyton's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Peyton's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back.
Nope, good stuff there.
Peyton's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short game.
Try this, please. Looks interesting.
The ninth play of the drive. From the shotgun. Mike Williams
And there's the touchdown. Mike Williams has become a favorite target here.
The lead here early in the second quarter, a good development for them in this game.
Yeah, nice. You know, they learned something.
I believe he was the one who caught the touchdown in the last game.
Good use, and they found a way to get down there and score a touchdown. That was a nice job by the offense.
All right, that was a little better.
Mason's taking a knee here, so the ball will be...
Yeah, that was a whole lot better, really, than offense in the last game.
Coming back onto the field here. Desperately.
Although I did have a couple nice possessions. Anyway, hopefully that'll be the consistent marking for the offense.
Again, you know what's going to happen? Those defensive players are going to be looking at them as they come off the field. They put this back out there already, so it's important to get a drive.
No, James Starks.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays
in the name of love. Before you break my heart.
We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half. Glad to have you back as we come out of the 2-minute warning here in the first half. The Colts from the 22.
Oh no, I'm not gonna have the lane. Wow. Good hustle there by the offensive lineman.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position,
They read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
Well, I haven't really tried throwing an HP screen here.
The Bears back on the field on offense. They've got to be pleased with the way their offense took shape on that previous drive, which went all the way for a touchdown.
The
calling card has always been the fact that they like to do both.
A little too fast there. It worked very well, though.
They did that in the last drive, and then they take advantage of the fact they're running it well, and then they play action pass or drop back. They get good protection, and they make it happen.
Boy, it's been a good mix so far, both the pass and run.
Yeah, that's what you want. You want to mix it up, keep that defense thinking, and that's when it works the best.
Inching closer.
He's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
So what we got on a little play action. We'll find Tammy there in the corner.
Second and goal from the four. Winston's gonna scramble.
Almost had it.
When you get third,
wow, that was a risky pass.
Who's willing to fight the hardest? We'll find out here in a second.
Just 4 yards away from the end zone.
It's gonna roll out to my right, but whoever that was made good pressure. It cut off my lane.
To Williams.
And there's Williams again for the touchdown. Just knows how to get open.
Back that time, put it right on the money. Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today.
All right, well, good defensive stand.
Put it right in there for the touchdown.
Interception, set up touchdown. Almost threw end zone interception myself.
Well,
I should say that. That wasn't working right. Almost threw an interception myself, except this one would have been in the end zone, which was a lot worse than what he did.
The Colts offense back on the field, trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity.
Football,
so you made that mistake. Let it go. Go out there, be aggressive, and see if you can score some points.
Too much time allowed there.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Griffin from the gun. The catch is made by James Stark.
Come here.
Browns all over that offense and brings him down.
Sit.
The Colts have it at the 44.
Oh, almost missed him.
That's an excellent job by the defense. Just gets quick penetration in there, hits the quarterback, and gets the sack.
Pretty close to going by him.
What a job by the defense in this situation.
Slippery little devil, you.
To get to the 43 to pick up a first. The Colts snap it at the 31.
Oh!
That's going to bring up fourth down.
The Colts know what a situation they were in.
Just let them run out the clock.
It was a tough one, third and long.
I am the Chicago Bears.
Well, they decide to run the football, and
so be the team in the navy blue.
It probably was going to lead to a mistake.
And so now they'll call on Jones to punt the football. We've reached halftime, and we'll be sending it back to our studio and Larry Ridley as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports. The second half is officially underway. Peyton's going to start his return.
Yeah, a little bit of running room there. Not too much, though. It is a nice team.
The Bears ready to go on the march again, and that's exactly what they've been doing here lately. They've taken it all the way down the field on their last two possessions for touchdowns. Phil, can they make it three straight?
Let me say this to you, Jim. It's just not that easy. As we're watching this game and how they're playing on the offensive side, they make it look easy. But
I was down there. I'm an all-around Chicago fan.
That's what you want to do. Just get a first down, especially when you're on top.
Of course, I'm going to think it's a nice team.
Keep the defense guessing. Make them react instead of attack.
He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Peyton's a dangerous runner when you give him
I was a fan of the Colts. I like Andrew Luck, too. I was a fan of them when Manning was in his prime there.
Second and eight. He'll throw it over the middle. Butler
probably should have waited a little bit longer.
Cook's a smart guy. He knows when you're running slant routes over the middle, you got to make sure you protect yourself. So he's under control, catches the football, gets to the ground. before those defensive players could really beat him up. Good solid gain and doesn't quite get the first down.
Peyton's going to secure the handoff.
Not much, but it'll get the job done.
Peyton's a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
Cammy might have an opening there.
First down at the 48. Launches it down the field. Wow, what a catch.
Nice bullet pass in there.
At the 24. That long gain sets them up here on this play. Sean Green making.
Yeah, it was nice that Peyton was able to go out on top. I mean, really, that Denver defense is what won them that Super Bowl, not so much Manning himself.
Coordinator's done a terrific job so far here.
But
today.
Manning's still a good enough quarterback to at least get it done offensively enough to allow the Denver defense to do the rest.
Third down, following the run. Peyton's got it on the handle.
Ooh, I don't think I got it. I hope I'm still fourth in inches.
Welcome back to this defensive showdown. The coach is
take
going
a risk
to go
here
for
and
it.
Go for it.
Quarter underway now.
Oh yeah, no problem.
Jim, the defense gives up the first down that time inside the red zone, but there's
some more time off
the
clock.
Let's see if they can hold him.
Peyton's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Gets about 4 yards that time.
Peyton's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Well, I can get them to waste a couple of their timeouts here.
Watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Wish I was at 17 points so they wouldn't call timeouts.
Running out here in the fourth quarter. They call his name again. Peyton's brought down after picking up 6 on this play. And the timeout is called, so we're going to take a quick break and return in just a moment. This long drive continues.
I do love to run. I'm trying to run out the clock. There's no purpose to throw it through the air and try to do something terrible, but when you have Walter Payton as your running back, you tend to run the ball more.
Not everybody's able to run the football in near the goal line for scores anymore in the offense. It's just too hard. But this offense, tough. The offensive line, give them credit. They gave the running back enough room, and he got in there for the score.
The Colts will now be in an even deeper hole here as they get ready to return the kick. Scores 21-0. Williams is going to drop to a knee here, so this will come out to the 20.
Pass offense
is
okay.
Is a field day
definitely
so
my
far.
Strength
They've
on
ready for just about
this
the
draft champions
tried.
Team
a
is
very impressive
run game.
Jim, they are whooping tail on the defense.
At least on
side.
Offensive side.
Way I can say it, they have been fun to watch physically, and they got a shutout goal.
That's his first reception today. Timeout won't be used here.
A little pressure here.
First down and 10. Two hands on the football and has the catch. Pass complete, but did not
have to
get
better
the
personnel
first, so
out here.
Down set up now at the 46. Griffin by himself in the backfield.
I'm mediocre at both. It really depends on the players I have.
Probably go as a drop.
But I'm in this draft champion round, I really didn't get much down. Many good options in terms of wide receivers and that.
Griffin's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
So it's a very, very mediocre passing team, but I got Walter Payton as my running back, so...
They bring back
now, luckily, when you have a running back that good, even if you're a mediocre runner, you can still make things happen.
The Colts come to the line, and they put their receivers in a bunch formation.
Plus, my offensive line is just absolute beast. I got a whole bunch of, like, I got Nick Mangold at 89, but then I got a bunch of, like, 90 overall rated players.
It
was good pass deflection there by Brock.
The Bears' offense takes the field, and what is, in essence, an encore bow to the crowd here, as they have been the dominant team all game long.
Probably could just kneel the clock out.
This is when I was at my best when I played, Jim. When we were winning, I came out there late in the game, too. I could kneel down and kill the clock as good as any quarterback in history. Second down following the run.
Normally, I like to air it out a little bit more, but again, not that strong of a passing team. If I had better wide receivers and maybe just a little bit of a better quarterback, at least more importantly, wide receivers, I might air it out a little bit more. Hey, still managed to put 21 points up on the board.
Donnie Jones now ready to punt. Well, Phil, I enjoyed watching the game with you, and how about a final thought about that victory?
Well, you know, Jim, I wish I could say the same, that I enjoyed spending these last 3 hours with you, but that's just not the case. But no,
yeah, seeing in this game actually had more passing
yards.
They've
done and celebrate a little tonight.
I think I'll see you next week, maybe. For Phil Sims.
All right. Once again, down to the all-important third game. I feel like there's more of a gap on this side of the controller for some reason. Interesting.
Two down, one big one to go. I'm Larry Ridley, and you're tuned to Draft Champions. The Bears come in knowing it only takes three, and the first two are out of the way, but it won't be easy. They'll match up here against the St. Louis Rams.
Randy Bullock ready to get this game started with the opening kick. The Rams are back deep.
I'm going to be facing in this one. Could pause it and find out. Find out the good old broadcast fashion way. Ooh, good kick.
We're underway here.
Well, Sammy Watkins. NBA career's going good. I just took a break just for today. Tom Brady, boy. I just took a break from it today just because it's 1 year anniversary on Twitch, and this is the game I started streaming with. Well, not Madden 16, but Madden 15. I should say game series. So just doing a little one-off throwback. But other than that, NBA, my career's going pretty well. Had a triple-double the other day.
First down at the 20.
Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. Quinn's all over the ball carrier.
Good job by the defense.
So I guess things can't be going too bad when I hit a triple-double.
And now they have a good situation.
Second down and 12.
Come here, Brady.
Throws the sideline, and what a catch.
Well, this defense covered four defensive
a second more,
back
and I would have gotten them.
It stops all the big passes down the field. But look at these crossing routes. Wide open, hit them, and let them catch it and run, and you still get the big plays.
First and 10. Catch made near the sideline.
Oh yeah, nice.
50-yard line on defense. You have to be careful now, because
I haven't quite gotten to that point.
Confidence. And what they're going to do here, they're
just
looking
lock
for
up and man a little bit better.
Quick score. So on defense, you better play safe.
First and 10. Brady handle. Rock for a loss on that play.
Oh, stuff in the run game.
You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're
trying
running the
get,
football.
Look to try to stop the pass game.
Take advantage of that. He tries for the big play, he gets tackled for a loss.
Second and 12. Matt Forte. He's tackled right at the 48.
Well, but it's third long in a situation like this. I'm going to look at it from the defensive side. You know they're going to be careful, so make sure you come up and just make the tackle so they don't get those yards after the catch or a long run.
All right. Now they're going to be passing.
The 36 is the first down line. The Bears' defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Snap back to Brady from the gun. He rips it.
Yeah, there we go.
Out of the wide receiver's hands.
Watkins is going to go back to the huddle and look at all of his teammates and go, my bad. Well, they know it's your bad. Everybody, even the offensive linemen, they saw you were open and you dropped the pass that was
right. Yeah, it wouldn't have mattered even if he made the catch. It would have been stopped short.
I think he will, and I'm sure the football will find its way towards him again soon.
Winston's, of course, going to be the man at quarterback today.
Well, a couple things I like about Jameis Winston. I like his size. I like his natural leadership abilities. And listen, he was groomed at Florida State to be a professional quarterback, so the transition for him should
all
be
right.
A lot easier than other rookie quarterbacks.
Just in case they don't show me, I'm going to take a quick peek at who I'm even facing here. Help if I'd go to their team. Campbell, Bennett. Nada. Flowers, Rogers, Cromartie, Joseph, McCourty. Okay. McCourty, Will Hill, so TJ Ward. All right.
Two tight ends on the field here. The Bears take it from the 23. Tackle made by Levy that time. One hulking. Major target in the passing game is tight end Jared Cook.
Well, yeah, he is. He's tall, and Jared Cook can really run. We've seen it for many years in the NFL. That's what you need now in your offense. You need a big tight end who is fast.
And it'll be second down and 6 after the running play on first down. Out of the shotgun.
Oh!
But couldn't hold on as the pass goes incomplete.
He jumped that route more than I thought he'd be able to.
Reliable Pro Bowl defenders in the game. Haloti Ngata.
Well, man, when he gets down that stance, he takes up enough space for two people. You take that, but plus he's strong, he has experience, and he's a tremendous athlete. That's why he's one of the best.
So we can get here on the crossing play.
Formation.
I think that should be enough. Okay, good. Whew.
That drag route across the field, it is not as easy as it looks. You're running fast, you have to catch the football right in stride, and you cannot see what's in front of you.
Stephen Tullett in on the play.
Peyton's
never able to build up that power that he has as a running back.
We keep finding holes, but man, it's a quick defense.
That's a short game.
The Bears still driving as the
closing them pretty quickly.
Underway. It's second down now, right around 3 minutes remaining before halftime. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
It should be a first.
Peyton's a great running back to have.
Up, oh, took it away to go to the replay.
He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now
yep, okay, good.
Three more chances.
The Bears have it at the 44. Takes it again. And that's Stephen Tulloch who brings him down.
Peyton's a dangerous runner.
They're doing a pretty decent job on stopping the first down run.
Good job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Second and six. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
Works.
That's a good job by the receiver running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws.
2 minute warning.
But he sticks it right on him for the completion.
Halftime, 2 minutes away. We're back and we're coming out of the 2 minute warning in the first half. Now first and 10. Peyton's taking the handoff.
Ah, there's some more room on first down.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second and short. Hills in on the tackle.
When you have an offense
now some
like
gaps
this,
are opening up.
First downs, not only are they moving in scoring position,
ooh, I did not want to do an HB toss. Those plays never work for me.
Quarter, right back to him. And picks up about three.
Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short game.
Play after play after play here on this drive. Peyton's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. Second down and seven. To Williams.
Ah, I knew that was too risky.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
Offense heading to the line for the 11th play of the drive. From the gun.
Oh, hello, James Starks, wide open. Makes for an easy first down.
Pick it up what he can, and he's very smart. Gets out of bounds to stop the clock.
Stepping up to the line at the line.
I mean, I ran first over there to get knocked completion. That was the goal.
Runs it across. Touchdown.
You got to give the offense.
That was more push out of bounds than just getting out of bounds.
Line up and power the football in there. Nice run, but a great job by the O-line.
The Rams are ready to return the kick.
All right. First offensive possession.
Watkins is going to
ran a lot of clock and ended up scoring.
And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line.
Now it's back to the defense.
The Rams didn't get much out of that last drive, so now here they come again on offense. I'm sure they're going to be a little bit more of an urgency to the offense this time.
Well, I'll just say this to you, Jim Nance. I sure hope so. After that last drive, that was just too generic. Wasn't very well thought out.
Delaney Walker.
What they're doing on the offensive side.
Got to give that defense a little credit, though, don't you?
Well, yeah, the defense did its job, but, man, that was pretty easy.
We have to worry about putting a spy on Brady.
It's second down and three. The hit. Out incomplete.
Good breakup.
That's interesting as you watch the receiver trying to make that catch. He knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
The Bears defense now is going to go nickel. The Rams take it from the 33.
Oh, Mosley with the pick. Nice play. Okay. Hey, break it up now.
What a time to throw a pick, Phil. This defense, though, has really stepped up today.
Yeah, it has.
About
it has
time
stepped
that
up,
card
you know,
came through for me.
The offense, that interception.
It's been playing very well in
game,
general.
When to be careful, and that was not the time to take a chance.
Peyton's brought down at the 21. The Bears signal for the timeout.
But that's the kind of plays I was looking for from drafting that card.
At the 21. First down at the 21. Gets the handle. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day. The offense stops the clock.
That
right
took
away
a couple shots to the end zone now.
Coming up, second down.
Hopefully, don't throw an interception myself.
Winston's going to take it from the gun. Brings it in. And Joseph in on the tackle. Third down now.
Now maybe.
Standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap.
Dang it. Oh!
Daniels with the sack. Going for it on fourth down.
Oh, wow. Whoops. I forgot it was fourth down already. Yeah, we're not going to go for it.
Take their final timeout. That's it. This will be a 41-yard field goal try.
And easy.
Put three on the board. The first half is complete.
All right, two possession lead.
Take things over back in our studio.
And get to start the second half with the ball.
The NFL on EA Sports. Peyton's got it. Gets out.
Very good position.
And brought down at the 24. The Bears will be trying to make it three successful drives in a row as they retake the field here on offense, partner.
They got a great feeling from the offense so far. In other words, they're confident, they feel good, so you need to keep calling plays that keeps the offensive players in a positive frame of mind. You do that, hey, I'm going to be surprised.
What did that get? 1 yard?
The key to being a really good
runner. I guess 1 yard's better than no yards.
And show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
Peyton's lined up in a single back formation to the ground. Peyton's taken down at the
That's
40.
A lot better.
He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top.
This is exactly why I run the ball.
Just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense. Managing
controlling,
so
well, when
today.
You pick up that many yards. Oop! Got caught up there on that one.
Able to read that play and make the hit.
Got to give the defense some credit on first down. There's so
drive out, Rams cross it. Let's go Rams cross.
Play clock's running down. Winston's got it in the gun. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands.
That's
got
to be third and inches. Okay, third and one.
Two for him.
Good job that time by the quarterback. Looks down the field. Nobody open, so he throws the drag route.
All right, come on, Peyton.
It's a nice catch. Just short of the first down.
Peyton's going to secure the handoff.
Muscle way forward there.
Four in a row. They come to the line.
Well, they had the position there to stop me, too.
Peyton's lined up as the single back. Another handoff right back to him. That's McCourty making the stop. Second and six coming up.
Show a little love here to the fullback.
For this one. And the immediate handoff to the fullback. And a gain of four.
Lateral.
Welcome back to the action on a day where defenses
right.
have ruled. It's third down now. Right around 3 minutes remaining in the fourth. The final quarter begins with this snap. Winston's on the
move. Oh, gosh. Oh, boy. Ah! Oh!
What a job by the
defender
that time.
I ran into some trouble there.
The quarterback and the receiver and being in position
to knock that football away.
Yeah, let's try to go for it. Played.
That's a clinic. Put that on the highlight film and show guys how to do it.
Payton's in the backfield. Single back set. Has the grab. Payton's marked down at the 34.
That paid off.
Gotta have a lot of courage to call these type of plays, don't you, Jim?
I have a lot of courage. I'm not afraid to go for it. Still up by double digits.
Winston's completion percentage 70% on the day.
Speared.
The Bears have stayed with the run game today, and it's been a big part of their game plan. Payton's been a consistent force on the ground.
That's a good place to just play it safe, run the ball.
It's arms, elbows, everything is moving, and he is one tough running back to tackle.
Waste as much clock as possible.
That's McCourty making the stop. Timeout's called, and we're going to step aside. Be back in just a moment. Mounting a serious drive. The Bears have it at the 24. Right back to him one more time. That's a timeout by the D. Double tight end formation.
Uh-oh. Ooh, nice spin move.
Huh. Tackle made by Bennett.
Something out of nothing.
The defense stops the clock.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Another carry.
How about that one? Oh, I need one more yard to get to 100. I was going to just kneel it, but I think I'm going to get to 100 yards with Payton.
Now becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
First and goal. They feed it to him one more time.
And there we go. 100 yards on the game. Perfect mark. Now we'll just run this clock out. Take a knee. Actually, probably have to take two.
Takes a knee.
Oh, yeah.
Only 9 yards to go. Third and goal from the 9. Chip shot here.
Kick a field goal just for fun.
And he puts it through for 3.
And run up the score a little bit more. Why not?
Efforts out there today that stood out, but in the end, it's a win for one side, even though the offense did not come out impressively.
When you see a low-scoring game like that, Jim, it means one thing usually: a lot of hard hitting. It was tough.
Tell you what, it's a story. Defense for this round of draft champions. I think I had shutouts in all 3 games, actually. Yeah.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nance saying so long.
Here, I thought that defense wasn't going to... was a little shaky, but no. That's solid pass defense. Of course, that line helped. Just really, very strong defensive line. Having that Mosley card there, too, helped. Open up these 2 packs here, and then, call it a stream for, well, at least for the short morning sports stream. Whoops. No, I don't want to quick sell that. Quick sell those. Derek Anderson. Name I haven't heard of in a while. I'm okay, Adam. I'm not gonna tout that I'm like the greatest player ever, but I seem to do okay for the most part. I guess a pretty average player at any sports game. So, but yeah, I'm not gonna go any more in that. I appear to be good, but that's against computers, and those usually are a different story. Against human players, then it gets a little iffy. But I'm pretty average in PvP or PvE aspects of sports games. So, but yeah, thanks for the compliment, though. I'm glad I at least appear to be somewhat good and know what I'm doing. But yeah, that's gonna wrap things up here on the short morning sports stream. Of course, this is just kind of a little one-off thing as a throwback to the Madden series, which is what I started streaming. I started streaming Madden 15 Ultimate Team, well, obviously a year ago since it's celebrating 1 year on Twitch. But yeah, the one-year celebration will continue this afternoon. I will be in Left 4 Dead, going to be finishing up the last couple Left 4 Dead 1 campaigns, and then probably getting started in a couple of the Left 4 Dead 2 campaigns. But again, I just want to say thank you to everyone. Again, just hitting 100 followers was, as I mentioned at the beginning of the stream, was a personal goal of mine to get there within a year. And that happened. In fact, it happened a week before a one-year anniversary. It happened last week, so I was very thrilled with that. So thank you to everyone, and thank you to everyone who continues to come back and watch. I definitely appreciate it all. Of course, he may never see this, but a big thanks goes to Ray Narvaez Jr., or Brown Man, as he knows. Ray, formerly from Rooster Teeth / Achievement Hunter. He was the guy who kind of inspired me to give streaming a shot. So while he may never see this, who knows? Maybe he will. Ray, if you do happen to find this, again, a big thank you to you for inspiring me to kind of give streaming a shot. And hopefully in the next year or so, build the community even more and continue to have a lot more fun along the way. So again, the celebration continues this afternoon with some Left 4 Dead campaign. Running down everything else, Twitter's at 4moresports. YouTube is youtube.com/DSADeathAndy589. You can find links to everything in the channel info section if you're watching on Twitch, or in the description area if you're watching this later on YouTube. If you are watching on YouTube, feel free to hit that subscribe button. Give this video a good old thumbs up. And, of course, if you'd like to help support the stream, you can do so by following me here on Twitch and continue to come back and watch yourself. You can donate to the stream to help keep things running, or you can help out by sharing the stream, because as I've always said, you know, I'll never shake you down for money. You're always welcome to come watch the stream. But if you want to help out and just sharing with friends, family, whoever, that'd be a big help. Any of those methods are a big help and are all greatly appreciated. So let's see, coming up schedule-wise, again, Left 4 Dead this afternoon, and then tomorrow should be a normal day. We'll get back to NBA 2K16, my career continuing year 4 there, and then be playing some more of the Gears of War 4 beta in the afternoon. So I think that covers everything now. Therefore, until the next time you decide to tune in, I will see you at that point. But until then, have a great day, everybody.